Hi, I'm Beth with 50 Plus Beauty, and I am so excited to share this video with you. I have been asking you if you would like to see how I accomplish my beauty routine, because many of you see all of the stuff that I do here on YouTube, and I have to admit that before I came to YouTube, I was much more simple in the things I did. I hardly did anything. I washed my face with alpha hydrox products. I used a little bit of retinol acid on my skin, not even Retin-a. I wore sunblock, which I had done since I was 35 years old, but I really didn't do a lot of beauty things in terms of a beauty routine. Like, I didn't do the NuFace then, I didn't do the face yoga, and now, for those of you who watch my channel, you know that I do a ton of different beauty things. And really, one of the main reasons that I do that is because I feel like I'm your beauty guinea pig here. I am 60 plus years old. I'm 62. I always want to make myself 63. But I do everything I can to try to look as good as possible, and I love to share the results with you. And so that's my job here on YouTube. And I have to admit, over the 3 years that I've been on YouTube, I've found some things that really do pack a lot of bang for their buck, and I think they really do work. And I'll be showing you how I accomplish them every morning, actually just Monday through Friday morning. I call this my Beauty Power Hour, and it's my fitness workout hour. And I combine my workouts with some other beauty things, which I'll show you in just a few minutes. And if you're not a subscriber to my channel and you're interested in all things anti-aging, I hope you'll subscribe and click that little bell to be notified of my future videos, and or give this video a thumbs up and or share it with a friend. Okay, so before I get into showing you the details of my 5 a.m. Beauty Power Hour that I do Monday through Friday morning, let me show you something that I do all night long to help me get my beauty sleep. And I absolutely love this pillow. This is the Sleep and Glow pillow. This version is called the Omni pillow. The Sleep and Glow pillow, I had that before. It was a slightly taller version of this pillow. And the Omni pillow is just a little bit shorter, which is really better for your neck. And I absolutely love this one. And what this does is it's a beauty product that removes wrinkles from your skin. And before I got this, and I've been using this or the Sleep and Glow pillow, this is the Omni or the Sleep and Glow pillow, I've been using them for over a year, and I really love them. And before that, I slept on a wedge pillow, and I slept on my back because back sleeping really does help remove the wrinkles from your skin. When we sleep, we are pressing wrinkles into our face and really not doing us any beauty favors at all. So if you'd like to make your sleep truly beauty sleep, I highly recommend this pillow. Number one, it is the comfiest, cushiest pillow you will ever sleep on in your life. I look forward to it every night when I get into bed. I'm like, oh, there's my Omni pillow. I'm so excited. But it allows you to sleep on your back if you're a back sleeper. And then if you want to sleep on your side, this pillow enables you to do that without crushing wrinkles into your skin. This is an example of me sleeping on this pillow on my side. And as you can see, I'm not all smushed up like I would be if I slept on a normal pillow. It has a little divot here that you fit your face into. And this side and this side keep your face supported. So this is the first very important element of my beauty power hour. Actually, this is my beauty, I would say 6 hours. I'm not great at getting 8 hours of sleep, but I get about 6 hours of sleep and I sleep on this pillow and I truly think it makes a wonderful difference. Okay, now I've talked long enough. Now let me show you my beauty power hour. Okay, I do my workouts Monday through Friday morning, and this happens to be a Monday morning. And I wash my hair on Mondays and Fridays usually, and I'll show you how I do that. Usually I put a conditioning mask on my hair and work out with it on my hair for that hour, but I'm not going to do that today because quite honestly, I would be wearing this all through the video and it's a little uncomfortable and I just didn't want to do that. And it is normally 5 o'clock in the morning when I get up and start my routine. However, it's about 4:30 now because with the filming on my cell phone, which that's my cell phone there that I'm filming on, it takes a little more time probably to do this video since I'll have to be doing some camera setup and that kind of thing. But the first thing I always do is I put the little drops of Lumify in my eyes because it helps them from looking so red and snake-like. Just do one drop in each eye. And then I go ahead and brush my teeth. And I use this Crest 3D White toothpaste. It has a little bit of grit in it. For those of you who are more mature like me, you'll remember the pearl drops, and it feels a little bit like pearl drops.
Okay, the teeth are all clean and the eyes are whiter, I hope. Now, mostly what I do is on Mondays, I also use Crest White strips on my teeth. So while I am working out downstairs, I have the Crest White strips on, but I tried that the other day and I could hardly talk, so that would not be good for the video. So normally I put the Crest White strips on, and as I mentioned, I condition my hair, and mostly I've been using this nutrient-rich coconut oil hair mask, and it is really good. And what I do is I get my hair wet in the tub, and then I towel it off, and then I apply this, and I put this little cap on top of my hair, and then I use this little heated cap, and you put this in the microwave for 90 seconds, and you put this on your hair, and it's just a warm cap that helps that conditioner sink in. This morning, because I'm in a hurry though, and because I didn't want to wear that the whole time I'm exercising with you, I'm going to be using this Phyto Extreme Keratin Hair Mask. And this one only takes like 3.5 minutes, and I do use this sometimes. More often I use the other, because I really do like that deep conditioning, the twice a week when I wash my hair. But I will be using this one today because I did want to condition my hair, but I did not want to wear the cap. Okay, now I'm going to leave the bedroom, and there's the living room, and there's the kitchen in there. And I'm just walking through here. There is my fall decor up table. I had never done fall decor until this year, and for some reason decided I would do it this year. And it was kind of fun, although orange is not my favorite color, I have to admit. Okay, and here I am. I've got my little stand there. This is my coffee bar area, and I always make myself coffee with collagen in the morning, and I do that in the Keurig, and I also go ahead and start Alan's coffee here. Okay, let me go ahead and get this process started. Here is my collagen, and I'm using this brand of collagen peptides. Really like this one, and it's reasonable in price. And then here is the coffee for Alan's coffee. And I go ahead first and make my Keurig. And in honor of the fall, I've been using this Keurig coffee. This is the Starbucks Pumpkin Spice Coffee. Absolutely love that. Take out the old one there. And then I just grab a cup here. And I have really been reading a lot about collagen because I wondered, am I just wasting money? Because I think this is maybe $35. My husband and I both do a scoop in the morning in our coffee. And so it gets expensive, but I was looking up the studies, and there really are a lot of studies that collagen, the hydrolyzed collagen, which collagen, the collagen in our skin, is just links of little round balls, kind of. They look like pearls. And that's how collagen comes out. And if you just take collagen the way it comes out of the cow or the pig or whatever, it's not going to help you. But it has to be hydrolyzed collagen, which means they break down the string of pearls on that collagen to 2 or 3 pearl links. And that's what this is hydrolyzed collagen. And they actually have done studies where they show that people who ingest this and mice who ingest this, after a certain amount of time, maybe 4 to 6 weeks, they are actually finding these little hydrogen collagen links in their skin. So in other words, the collagen from the jar here is actually getting into your skin, which is just wonderful. And so what I do is I make my coffee, and I'll go ahead and make Alan's coffee too here. And there's none left, so we're good there. Let me go throw the old coffee away. Oops, forgot the water. That would help, wouldn't it? And I'm going to go throw this away. And normally, as part of this process, I would unload the dishwasher. And it does need it, but I'm not going to do it because it's too hard to get this camera over there. So I'll get him some water. And I'm going back in the laundry room to get my water because we have filtered water, and the spigot for that is back in the laundry room. And so I always use filtered water to make the coffees. And Alan's, I won't run his through because it's only 5 o'clock in the morning and he doesn't get up till 6 or 6:30. But I just kind of get this ready for him. And this is a wonderful little coffee carafe that I got in Kansas City. My kids lived in Kansas City at one point, and they invited us to Kansas City. And they took us all around one Saturday to all the sites of Kansas City. And one of them was this coffee roasters called the Roastery, I think, in Kansas City. There is that coffee. And I just do 2 scoops of that. And this keeps the coffee fresh. And we bought this when we were visiting that coffee roastery or whatever. You just put this on here. which keeps the coffee fresh. And then you just put a clear plastic lid on it. This is actually the Starbucks pumpkin spice coffee in the loose ground, which is here in the coffee maker for Alan. And it's not as good as the Keurig version. I don't know why. But anyway, I'll just leave that for him. And then here is my Keurig coffee. And I love Keurig coffee. It is so good. And unfortunately, I forgot to add the collagen. Normally, I add the scoop of collagen. There's a scoop. Normally, I do that at the bottom of the empty cup, and then I don't have to stir it up. And actually, mostly, I don't stir it anymore. I used to stir it, but now it seems like it just dissolves in there without really any stirring, which is great. And so I guess I'll stir it with my finger, just so it looks a little better to you guys. And so there is how that coffee looks. I probably do need a spoon. Okay, here's a spoon. And so there is how that stirs up, and it totally dissolves it. And actually, if I had gone ahead and put it at the bottom of the empty cup and then let the coffee pour over the top of it, it really would not need stirring at all. But there is that. And it really doesn't have any taste. Maybe it tastes a little bit creamier, but you really can't tell at all, and I like it. Okay, that's again a look at my Keurig coffee area, and there's the laundry room. And I will tell you one more thing, is that I also make broccoli sprouts, and I just started them, so you can't really tell, but you just make them in a little jar like this, and every morning you add water. I started with 2 tablespoons of broccoli sprouts, and they are super, super, super good for you. But you just add water there, and you just rinse them every morning and evening for maybe 3 or 4 days is all. And in 3 or 4 days, I'll end up with a whole jar full of broccoli sprouts. And I have 2 jars, so I kind of keep them rotated. Broccoli sprouts are super good for you. And I just tip it up in that little plastic bin there, and then you cover it up because it likes to be in the dark. So anyway, there's some masks that I washed. And I'm taking Alan's cell phone with me because whenever I do my morning routine, which is 5 days a week, I always watch YouTube videos on my cell phone or I listen to Audible books. And so we're going downstairs to the basement. So I've got Alan's cell phone here to be able to watch my YouTube videos on. He has a smaller cell phone, so it's not gonna be as much fun. And actually, I guess I could go get my iPad, that'd be good. Okay, and this is the basement. Here we go, I come down here. And I do turn this light on so it's not so dreary looking. There's the little bar. And there's my setup here to be able to film this morning. Got my coffee, love my coffee. Couldn't do this morning without my coffee or my YouTube videos or Audible books. It just is a fun part of my day. Okay, I think because I'm filming, I really got out of my sequence this morning. But in addition to forgetting to put in my contacts, which I did, I also forgot to take my supplements. I usually grab these out of my cabinet and take them along with my coffee. So I'm going to do that for you. And here we go. Today is Monday, so I'll go ahead and take Monday's supplements. I prepare them whenever I run out, which is usually on Sunday. Okay, I just take them. As you can see, taking pills does not really bother me. Okay, now it's time for the workout, and I won't break too much during the workout to show you what I'm doing. But basically, I like to have 1 to 3 minutes between each set of reps that I do. You're supposed to do that. And so what I do is that in some of those little breaks, I insert other things, like I do my NuFace and my face yoga exercises during this period, which you'll see a little bit later. I don't know that I'll show you this whole workout routine because I do have a video of my morning workout routine, and I'll link that below in case you're interested. But I'll just kind of zoom ahead in all of this so you just get a sense of what I'm doing. One other thing is that I should have really done this for you on Tuesday morning, because Tuesday and Thursday mornings I do my arm routine, and my arm routine is a lot shorter. And so in addition to doing my arm routine on Tuesday, I also do my aerobic exercise, and I do that 3 times a week. I do it Tuesday, Thursday, and then either Saturday or Sunday. And I just use my little recumbent bike here, which I will show you in a few minutes. But I don't do that on Monday because this workout, which is lower body, takes longer. So I don't do aerobics at all on Monday. So at the end of this workout, although I'll show you what I normally do, I'll get on the bike and show you how that works, because I do use my iRestore hair helmet, and sometimes I use the ice under my arms to kind of work on the fat pockets underneath my arms. But again, I don't normally do that on Mondays, so I'm not really going to do that, but I will show you how that works. Okay, and because it's long, it's 42 minutes long, I'm going to be watching a Marissa Peer video this morning. Actually, not watching, I'll be listening to it as I'm doing my workout. But this one is called Reprogram Your Mind for Success, which that is not necessarily the type of thing I usually listen to, but it is 42 minutes long, so that will be really good. I really watch YouTube videos more often than not that have to do with health or working out, something like that, because that's an area that I'm into right now. But I'll go ahead and get that started. I just can't imagine doing my workouts without hearing some positive audio when I am doing it.
No cord packing. I think that was a bad idea.
There's a commercial there. It's my husband's. He didn't get rid of the commercials. Hate political commercials. Okay, here's the beginning of that.
Reprogram your subconscious mind for success. Remember, it has a job, and its job is to do what you tell it. Your job is to tell it exciting things, understand.
Woohoo! Exciting things. Okay, now it's time to start my workout routine. But first, I do a little posture set of exercises, and they feel so good. And here they are. And again, I have a video that explains these, so I'll zip through these really fast. Lie on the bolster and just kind of relax your shoulders down. That's the first step. Okay, now I'll get started with my workout.
Really important why you don't yet love yourself.
And I put these on my shoulders because I was getting bruised before when I would set the bar on my shoulders. So I don't like that. And then I do 10 to 15. But again, I won't be explaining my exercises to you. Now, in this rest break, I'm going to do my little plank exercise for my abs. That really does help the abs get tired.
Make you feel as lovable as you already know that you are. So you have to fall in love with you. And once you do that, it's a game changer. When you fall in love with yourself, it's a lifelong romance. Share, sign up, help. You have to feel lovable. Now I can hear the question, but yeah.
Now,
how?
Between that and the next step, I'm going to do a little straddle stretch, and I do 1 minute in the middle, 1 minute this side, 1 minute this side. It won't be exact because normally I face that way to watch the clock, but I can't this time.
You're the best thing that happened. Where all those songs go, I can't live without you. You're the best thing that ever happened to me. So say it to yourself. Think of what you most want to hear and say it. Hey, I love you. I'm in love with you. You're amazing. Every time you go past the mirror, there you are. Look at you. You beautiful creature, look at you, you are lovable.
Ooh,
you allow the whole world to see that of course you are lovable just the way you are. Breathtaking model who said all the men I date diminish me, put me down because they feel I'm too beautiful for them. Beautiful, beautiful man was unhappy. So if you want to feel lovable, fall in love with yourself. Damaged people.
These are heavy.
Start from being hurt.
I think they're about 12 pounds each.
Maybe more.
And you heal your very soul when you fall in love with yourself. People, habits of success. There are habits also that destroy success. They interfere with your ability.
Next, I do my back kicks with my booties.
One of those habits is being a perfectionist, believing that it'll be perfect. You know, we train people in our TT, my own version of our homes, and I notice that I look in the class and say to my sister, gosh, you know, too perfect to take those actions. Another habit that stops success is doubting yourself. What if, what if, what if?
About halfway through my workout, and at this point I'm going to incorporate my NuFace next in one of the rest breaks, and it probably takes me 5 minutes rather than three, but I'm tired at this point and so I could use the 5 minute rest. So I'm going to change the camera and show you my NuFace routine. Then I'm going to clean off the gel on my face. Now I'm going to do my next. And this feels really good to have a break from working out. Because I get really tired. That was the first half of my workout. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and do my face yoga routine, which I think has really, really helped. And I'll link those videos below. My eyebrows are wonky. And again, I'm not going to show this to you in depth. I'm going to zip through it because I do have a video that shows you all of these exercises in minute detail. Okay, here we go. Wow. Wow. Wow.
Happy. I'm choosing to be happy right now.
Ooh, that feels good. And you know, it's funny. I've been listening to this Marissa Peer video, and I think it's on being happy. I don't know. I just kind of selected it because it was 42 minutes long, and it is phenomenal. It's all about loving yourself, and I'm definitely going to link that below. And if you can watch that, I think it's great. And I think I'll listen to it on multiple mornings because there's a lot in this. In fact, it's about to end, and before it flips to something else, I'm going to go save it because I will keep listening to it because it is wonderful. Okay, next I'm going to do my deadlifts, which is a lower body exercise. And to do that, I'll change out the bar. Okay, next I'm going to do the deadlift, and that is a great lower body exercise from here on down. Hips and thighs. Now when I do my last exercise here, it's a hip thrust, and so I put this little cushion on the bar because otherwise I bruise myself, which is not good.
How do you love yourself? Well, first of all, it is vital, essential, crucial for you to love yourself, worth it. Then they don't think you're worth it. So what I see so many people doing is trying to make someone else love me. I'm going to find this guy and try to make him love me. I'm going to find this girl, this woman, and try to make them love me. I'm going to run after love, chase after love, work so hard on it. And love being super good, or super hot, or super nice, or you feel good about me.
Woo! That was the end of my workout. It feels good to be on this side of it. This last part of the Beauty Power Hour, I am really not doing today because I do this Tuesday and Thursday because, again, as I mentioned before, when I do my arm routine, it's a lot shorter, and so I have an extra half an hour Tuesday and Thursday at the end of my weight routine for my arms to be able to do my bike because my bike takes 30 minutes, and so I'm really not going to do this today. But how we make the bike do double duty is that as I'm doing my high intensity interval training, and what that is that you have a little timer and I set it for 30 minutes, and for the first minute I go as hard out as I can, and then the second minute I kind of amble along, and then the third minute I go as hard as I can, and then 1 minute ambling along. So it's basically short intervals of high intensity training every other minute. And at the end of the week, I've got 45 minutes of the HIIT training, which you're supposed to have 50, but I think that's pretty good. But I'm not going to do that today again because I have to get to work and it's getting late. But while I'm doing that, I wear my iRestore helmet, and I won't put it on for you, but basically you turn this on and you do it and it takes 25 minutes. And I really do like that because that gets 2 of the 3 days out of the way easily because I'm doing my bike anyway. So I do wear the iRestore helmet. I took my hair down thinking I was going to show you, but I won't be showing you, so I'll put my hair back up in a nub again. And as I'm doing my iRestore helmet, on many days, I don't do this every time I do it, but on many days, I use these little ice packs that I have put in t-shirt material, and I just put them under my arms like this. And I have a video about this. So basically when I do my biking, I've got the helmet on and I've got these ice packs under my arms, and I just sit here like this and I do my biking. And what that is doing is that is slowly dissolving the fat pads that I have under my arms. And I won't do this forever, and my underarms are getting much, much better. And in fact, I'll link a video below that shows you my progress in, I think, just a month doing this, and it's pretty amazing because I used to have a lot of fat under my arms. And now it's manageable. It's not very much, you know, it's fine. So I may stop doing this pretty soon. But basically, as I'm doing my HIIT training, I'm doing the iRestore helmet and hopefully encouraging my hair to grow, and I'm improving my underarms as well. So that is a look basically at my Beauty Power Hour. And after I'm done here, I go upstairs and take a shower. And before I do that, I take all my clothes off and I weigh. And I do weigh every morning, because I used to not do that, and what would happen is I'd weigh every week or two, and every now and then I'd have a very unpleasant surprise that I gained 5 or 6 pounds. And so now I make myself get on that scale every single morning, and it's wonderful because if I'm just up a pound or two, I can watch that day, and the next day I'm exactly where I would like to be. And I do have a range of where I would like to be. I'm 5'6". And I like to be 120 to 122, somewhere in there. So anyway, that was a look at my Beauty Power Hour, is what I call it. And many of you have asked how I can do all of these beauty things so easily, and does it take me all day? And no, it really doesn't, because most everything I do, except for skincare, is encompassed within my Beauty Power Hour. It's kind of my time that I get to devote to myself. And while I'm going through my Beauty Power Hour, it's interesting to me because I use that as a time to learn, either through watching YouTube videos about subjects that are interesting to me at that point, and I tend to go through lots of different interests in a year. It's pretty amazing. I love to learn new things, or through just listening to positive, uplifting audiobooks or videos. Well, that was a look at my Beauty Power Hour, and if you have things you do to incorporate beauty tips and tricks into your routine, I hope you'll share them in the comment section below. Take care, and I'll see you in my next video.